In this tutorial, we'll be looking at the fixture libraries that are available. We'll create our own fixture files and look more closely at the internal fixture builder in the Chimp. Thank you for your interest in the Infinity Chimp Light Controller, and welcome to this tutorial. To learn more about the various parts of the Infinity Chimp Light Controller keyboard and screen, you are advised to watch Tutorial 1 and 2, Hardware and Software. This tutorial is based on software version 1.3. If your Chimp uses a different software version, the functions or user interface may be different. Please note that we refer to the Chimp hardware keys as keys and the GUI software keys as buttons in this tutorial. Chimp libraries. We'll start by going to the Chimp's fixture library. Press Setup, followed by Fixture Library. We now see three different fixture libraries: the Factory Library, User Library, and Show Library. The Factory Library is the Chimp's default library and contains more than 17,500 fixtures. It is maintained by Atlabase. The fixtures in this library cannot be modified. The user library can be populated by the user from the factory or show library. The fixtures files in the user library can be modified. The user library will not be overwritten when software updates are being carried out. The show library is created for each individual show file. As soon as a fixture is patched, it is stored in the show library. The show library is also stored in the show file and will be exported when a show is saved to an external USB storage device. Fixtures in show library are not available in other shows, so they need to be copied over to the user library. Files in the show library can be modified and will not be overwritten when a software update is carried out. Create a fixture file. We'll now create a new fixture. Press Add Fixture, and the following screen will be displayed. At the top left, we need to select whether we'll create a new fixture or use an existing fixture as a basis. To select a template, we need to check this option and press the Select Template Fixture button. We now see the Select Fixture screen. As an example, we'll select the IS-200 in an advanced mode and press OK. In the template selection, we can now see the selected fixture, which you can modify if you wish. In our case, we'll create a new fixture file, so we need to select Create Empty Fixture. To start with, we need to specify a manufacturer by entering it on the keyboard. In our example, we're using fictitious names, so we'll type Monkey followed by Enter. We then need to specify a fixture type. Use the keyboard again. We'll then enter the desired name and press Enter. Short type is automatically populated, but can be modified if necessary. Short type is the name that is displayed in the programmer. Finally, we need to specify the mode. In our case, we'll use basic mode. Now that all the names have been entered, we need to press Next. We can then enter the number of DMX channels and create the fixture file with Create. This brings us to the following screen with two tabs: Channel Setup and General Setup. If we press General Setup, we have the option of adding additional information: category and author. We are going to create a moving head, so we'll enter Moving Head. Author is self-explanatory and is none other than Thomas. We'll now go to the Channel Setup tab to enter the channel distribution. We have entered 10 channels and can see 10 blank channels in this overview. We'll select the first channel and press Set to assign it. A new screen opens up and we can see all available parameters in a list. These can be freely selected. Down the right-hand side, there are various filters that allow us to select the desired parameters more quickly. At the top, we can enter a search term. Below that, there are a number of filters for each attribute. We can also specify if we want to see all parameters or only those that have yet to be assigned. And finally, we can select whether to display 8-bit or 16-bit channels. We refer to these as coarse and fine. We'll firstly select Pan from the list and press OK. A second method for assigning a parameter is to double-click on the desired channel in the GUI. We'll select Tilt as the second channel. You can now see that Pan has disappeared from the list, as it has been assigned and the filter is set to unassigned parameters. We'll select the third channel and press Set. We'll now use the filter position attribute to be able to select PT speed quickly, and we'll press OK. As the fourth DMX channel, we'll assign the color macro with the attribute filter again. Channel 5 will turn red. We can select this channel with the aid of the text filter. We'll now complete the other channels with the desired parameters. In our example, we don't have a dimmer. If a fixture does not contain a dimmer, we can enable a virtual dimmer, which we can find at the top right of the screen. The virtual dimmer allows us to work with a dimmer in the programmer if the fixture doesn't contain one. In our case, we do have a dimmer, and the fixture appears to have two additional channels. As such, we'll add two channels with the help of a pen channel. We'll enter 2 and then press Append Channel. Channel 11 then becomes Dimmer 1, and Channel 12 becomes Shutter 1. We've also forgotten the 16-bit channels for Pan and Tilt, so we need to insert a channel. Select the channel where this must be inserted and press Insert Channel. We'll enter one channel using the Fine filter and select the 16-bit Pan channel. Then, we'll do the same for the Tilt channel. Select the desired channel, press Insert Channel, and then use Set to add the parameter. Channel Settings. We have now assigned all of the parameters. Each parameter has a number of settings that are created automatically. These can be modified afterwards. The first column we see is entitled Dimmable. If this is set to Yes, the dimmer will respond to Master and Group Dimmers. Then we see Type, in which we can specify whether or not a parameter should respond to fade times. Fade means that the parameter will respond to fade times. Snap means the parameter will ignore the fade times. We can change this with the Set button. The default values are the DMX values that the chimp outputs if there is no programming and if no playbacks are active. We'll change shutter to 10 with the help of the set button. With 10, the shutter will remain open. With the blackout setting, we can enter values that the chimp needs to output as soon as the blackout command is executed by the grandmaster. The highlight settings are the values that the chimp outputs as soon as the fixture is selected in the programmer and the highlight button is pressed. The ranges column shows which ranges have been entered for which parameters. We'll now add this for our color macro channel. Select No for the color macro parameter and press Set. We now see a new screen with the Add Range and Delete Range buttons. Let's click on Add Range to assign DMX values and enter a name. The drop-down menu also gives us the option of assigning an icon and a single or double color. The icon color and name are shown in the programmer once they have been set here. As we can see, preset colors are available, or we can set our own color with the color picker. This allows us to assign a complete channel distribution. We have already seen the options available for colors, but Fixture Builder has a wide range of icons that can be used for gobo channels. We'll now see how a fully populated range looks. Let's press OK to confirm. In the overview, we can now see Yes in the Range column. We can use Invert to invert the channel. Consider pan or tilt whenever you want to equate a zoom channel in terms of its operation to another fixture that responds the other way around by default. The DMX min and the DMX max settings are used to assign a minimum and maximum value to a parameter if, for example, we want a dimmer to output a maximum of 50% due to power supply limitations. We can limit the dimmer here to value 128. Thank you for watching this tutorial. Infinity strives to keep its chimp-related tutorials and software information up to date. Keep an eye on our social media channels for the latest information on the chimp.